At 1200 degree centigrade, the standard Gibbs energy of thermal decomposition of 1 mole of austenite into Fe and O2 is 168 kilojoule. We have to find out the corresponding dissociation pressure in natrium. And the second question is, given for the reaction 2CO plus O2 to CO2, the standard Gibbs energy is minus 310 kilojoule. What is the equivalent partial pressure of CO by partial pressure of CO2? So first we will write the dissociation or decomposition of austenite reaction, FeO2 Fe plus O2 half O2. So for this reaction, delta G naught value is given 168 kilojoule, and we know delta G naught equal to minus RT ln K, where K is equilibrium constant. So we can write 168 into 10 to the power 3 joule equal to minus R value, we know 8.314. This is joule per Kelvin mole. Temperature is given 1200 degree centigrade, so we can write 1473 Kelvin. And ln K, ln K is partial pressure of O2 to the power 1 by 2 into activity of Fe divided by activity of FeO, and this is at 1200 degree centigrade. So activity of FeO can be assumed as 1 and activity of Fe as 1. So we will get ln partial pressure, square root of partial pressure of O2 equal to minus 168 into 10 to the power 3 divided by 8.314 into 1473. So we can write minus 13.718. So partial pressure of O2 will be 1.2148 into 10 to the power minus 12. So here we can write it is nearly 1.22 into 10 to the power minus 12 atm. So here option B is the correct one. And for question 53, for this reaction 2CO plus O2 2CO2, standard Gibbs energy is given minus 310, it is kilojoule, so we have converted now it into joule, 10 to the power 3 joule equal to minus RT ln K. So minus R value we know 8.314 T. This is same temperature, so it will be 1473 Kelvin into ln. For this reaction, partial pressure of CO2 square by partial pressure of CO square plus into partial pressure of O2. So we can write partial pressure of CO2 square by partial pressure of O2 into partial pressure of CO square. It will be equal to 9.8498 into 10 to the power 10. We know this partial pressure of O2 from question number 52. So partial pressure of CO2 by partial pressure of CO whole square will be equal to 0.12016. and it is asking partial pressure of CO by partial pressure of CO2. So partial pressure of CO by partial pressure of CO2 will be equal to 1/0.12016 square root. So it will be nearly 2.8847. So we can write this as a 2.89. So option D is the correct one for question 53. Reference book for this question is this one. Thank you.